You can save yourself a lot of time and effort in Adobe Flash if you can learn how to duplicate and modify symbols. This especially comes in really handy when creating buttons. For instance, in this animation, I've created one button already called the replay button. And as you can see, I've already changed the states. The outstate has a hot pink color, overstate has green, and downstate has blue. In addition, it has a thick white border on the outside, it's a specific size and placement on the page, and it has a certain font. Now, if I tried to create a second button, let's say a button at the start of my animation that people could click and it would start it, if I wanted to recreate this button from scratch, it would take a lot of effort on my part because I would have to know what particular shade of pink and green and blue I used, how big was this font, where was it placed inside the button symbol, and how big exactly with height this background shape is. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'll duplicate this button and I'll modify it. Instead of saying replay, it's going to say start. So I'll go to library and I have my symbol, the button replay symbol right here, and I can right click on it and choose duplicate. And I'm going to change the name to BTN start and click OK. Now, right now, even though they have two different symbol names, they still look the same in the preview. That's because I have to go in and modify this button. So I'll double click on the button here, and on the first upstate, I'll come in here and instead of replay, type start. And then I'll go to the overstate, again, start. And then the downstate, and you can see I'm not moving or resizing any of the text. I'm just typing the exact same word in each so that it doesn't look like it has any little jumps anywhere. So now when I go back out to scene one and I look in my library, the start button now looks different than the replay button. So I can go ahead and create a new layer, and the start button is going to be all the way at the beginning of my animation. So I'll double click and type start BTN, and on this keyframe right here, I'll drag that start button in, and there we go. Now I might need to shut off simple buttons so I can move it, and the only thing different about this is that it's going to be a little bit different in terms of where it's placed on the page. So I can go back to that replay button and click on it, and it is at 102.95 and 105. So I'll click on the start button and do 102.95 and 105, and they should be in the exact same spot. Now I don't want that start button to last any longer than the first frame, so I do need to come back here and click and then hold shift and click the last frame, right click and remove them, because I only want it to appear on frame one, and then a user's going to click and it's going to play that animation. But now those two buttons are in the exact same spot, they're the exact same shape and height and colors and font. The only difference is the change in the word. You can do the same thing with all the other symbols. I can right click a movie clip symbol and duplicate it and change that particular movie clip, and same thing with a graphics symbol.